This video provides an overview of the resources available to you through the Health Sciences Library. It also contains resources for individuals who come from a non-science background. To navigate to the Anatomy and Physiology LibGuide, begin at the Health Sciences Library homepage, select Guides and Tutorials, and Explore. Then scroll down to Anatomy. This LibGuide is a starting point for learners. It contains standard anatomy and physiology textbooks that are used by the anatomy department at McMaster University. It also contains links to common textbooks. For example, Atlas of Anatomy by Gilroy, the Guyton Textbook of Medical Physiology, and Tortora's Principles of Anatomy and Physiology. The Gilroy and Guyton books are electronic, whereas Principles of Anatomy and Physiology by Tortora is only available in print. Students can purchase an electronic version through platforms such as VitalSource. If you scroll further down, you will find links to some common book packages that contain anatomy and physiology content. One common way to search for this content is to search across an entire book package. Let's go into Clinical Key and search for acidosis, which is a common term. Clinical Key contains a wide variety of information and over 1,000 books. When searching for this type of information, you will want to limit your topic to books. Otherwise, you will get hundreds of entries. So let's search for acidosis. As you can see, chapter excerpts come up in the search result. As you become more familiar with the key textbooks in your field of study, you'll be able to select the most appropriate chapter. For example, this entry is coming from Brenner and Rector's The Kidney. Let's take a look at TEMA Med1 Education. We will search acidosis. Similar to Clinical Key, the results are organized according to chapter. And finally, let's take a look at Access Medicine. The search results bring up a chapter from Harrison's Principles of Maternal Medicine, which is quite relevant. This book package contains a smaller number of ebooks than Clinical Key, and therefore searching across the entire platform is not so overwhelming. Another option available to you is to search the catalog. Navigate to the Health Sciences Library homepage, and the search box appears on the right. It should be noted that the catalog would search across title or chapter title. It does not search full text. Once your search results appears, select ebook and sort by date. This will get the most current information at the top. As you can see, the Handbook of Nephrology is certainly a book that would contain information on acidosis. The final resources to point out from the Anatomy and Physiology page are resources for students from a non-science background. This information was gathered by faculty from Student Affairs. It points to Principles of Anatomy and Physiology, which is a more basic text than the Guyton. It also mentions Campbell's Biology and Freeman Biological Science. As you can see, faculty have taken the time to point out specific chapters that you may find useful in your course of study. In summary, the Anatomy and Physiology Guide is a starting point for students. Students may wish to search the catalog for anatomy and physiology content, but a better approach may be to go directly into an ebook platform. The key platforms to keep in mind are TEMA Med1, Clinical Key, and Access Medicine.